Okay, can we start, please? Welcome to the second evening of this. I have turned it on. Can you not hear?
Yeah, but you have to speak inside.
Okay. Okay. All right, welcome to the second evening of this series of artist talks. Next week we'll have Matt Collishaw, and as replacement for Mary Kelly, who, as I said, has pulled out, we're going to have Paul Pfeiffer. And you can see details of this on both the AA website and the consortium website. This evening I would like to welcome Melik Ohanian. Is that how you say your name?
Yeah.
Melik works in Paris and first showed there at the Palais de Tokyo in 2002 and at his gallery, Chantal Cluzel. 2 years later, he showed in three biennales, Berlin, Sydney, and Sao Paulo. The following year, in 2005, he was in the first Moscow Biennale, and in 2006, he had his first solo show?
Yeah.
His first solo show at the Institute of Contemporary Art in Villeurbanne. Melik's work centers around the themes of time and of invisibility, amongst much else. And I'm very much hoping that he will speak about some particular works. First, in relation to time, the multi-screened 7 minutes before, which was shown at the Lyon Biennale in 2005, and later in London at South London Gallery. And in relation to invisibility, I'm hoping he'll say something about his 2005 Invisible City, a film inspired by Peter Watkins' 1971 Punishment Park. It is this theme of the invisible that first made me want to invite Melik to speak here. I had picked up a book titled Void and Voice in the Camden Arts Bookshop. And in it, I read about this man who wanted to film some non-event that he'd heard about somewhere, in the desert somewhere. And I was really interested. But I can't tell you in detail about it because the book has disappeared. I'm not sure that the project was ever realized, but I do ask Melik to tell us about it this evening, perhaps in the discussion. So I'm very pleased to welcome Melik Ohanian.
Thank you. So I decided to speak about a big project that I just finished in Paris in the last 6 months. It was just finishing in March, and it was starting in September. And it's quite specific because the project is called From the Voice to the End. And I was decided to work and to really integrate the notion of exhibition inside the work itself. So I decided to organize a kind of coexistence exhibition in 15 places at the same time, questioning different aspects of my work on one way. So it was made with new production, but it was a question to make a new position for my work too at the same time. So for example, if the starting point was that, so I was invited by three different places. They invite me to have a solo show in Paris in September 2008. And instead of saying no to the one or to make the choice to do the one or not the other, I decided to let appear this reality of coexistence project. And so I take these three places. I was working on two architectural commons, two at the same time for September 2. So it was another side of the realities at this moment. The radio, the national radio, was proposing to me to make a program. So I decided to make it at the same time too. And I was deciding to reorganize, or to try to find a new way to show my work more closer from the preoccupation of the inside of the work more than thinking that the art center is the place where you can show and where all the questions are in action. And so all my preoccupation about social have to be in the social part of the city. All my reflection about cinema, experimental ones, have to go back to a classical movie theater. I was making some performance with living process and different things. So my idea tonight is just to go through Paris in these 15 places and to speak about the works that were shown. And so I will do it place by place simply. And so the idea was to just classify these places by a number without making more important an institution, for example, because I don't know if you know these places, but there is the Art Center of Beaubourg, for example, where I was asking to show a piece that they have in their collection. But at the same time, I was in the smallest places in a suburb of Paris, really small thing for neighborhood social action. But at the end, everybody was on the same level, and the exhibition was really exploded through the city. So it was the space notion. At the same time, so I made this. So actually, I'm just showing that from the website of the show that you can consult after. And so there was this duration timeline that was a kind of tool to make a possible travel to these exhibitions. And so let's go to the map and let's go by place. So each places have really a different character. For example, this first one, it's called Abbaye de Maubuisson, which is in the suburb of Paris. It's a place for contemporary art, but originally it's a old construction from the 13th century. And it's really an art place to work because it's really a whole building and patrimonial things. It's a monument historique as this kind of place, it's not easy to work in. But it was part of this project to say, okay, I have to get the reality of each places. I don't want to make some shows in different places, and because I'm making this big show, which will be in already 15 different places, so I didn't want that one places have this notion of exhibition for itself. I wanted to be totally included in the space as more as possible, and try to make this exercise in each place. So it's one place of this Abbaye de Maubuisson, which is a old grange, I don't know in English. And so I was working, I have decided to, since a long time, to build a huge hamac, a collective one. So finally I went to Mexico and in a small village where they were producing some hammock, and so I went there without saying that we will produce a kind of art object, but I was more focused about the collective production of this object. So all the village finally was producing this 41 meters hammock, which was taking place in this Abbaye de Maubuisson. So I will just go for all the pieces, because you have to try to make a kind of picture of this whole, and after that we can speak more clearly about different things if you want. So I go straight forward. Then in other pieces, I was showing this work that I'm working since 2005, which is called Dacha Project. It's a small house that I was buying in the mountain of Armenia, where I'm originally coming from. And it's a place that I call a zone for no production. So I'm inviting people over there just to produce nothing. So they are really invited in a time notion, or nothing else. And this little house is just placed in a really small desert village, kind of. And I call it a kind of observatory from a minority. And so this process was starting since 2005. And I was defining that there will be not any representation for it of what was the time when 10 people were over there. But I decided to produce a kind of strange distance representation with different material or ideas or whatever. But the reality over there is not described. It's possible to showing any document that will be shot in these places can be represented 10 years later. So I try to put to make this gap between the reality and the representation time. So for example, here it's only the dimension and the measurement of the house itself. I was producing to this model in polystyrene, which is a confusing scale between the country, the landscape where the house is, and the house itself, and these three views are mixed. In fact, I'm producing this kind of imaginary territory of the project itself. And I was producing this T-bricks machine, so I was exciting to define my own module to make the extension of the house. So I was producing this machine that producing bricks, but in T form. I was researching to this notion of modules and looking for my own modules in front of the project. And so finally, we are producing more than 400 bricks for the exhibition, but this machine will go to Dacha in Armenia, and we will produce the extension of the house with this kind of bricks. And in another space, so I was making this, I will show you from there, sorry, grip. So I wanted, because there is a big park in this place, so I decided to propose a work for the outside. And I decided to make this football game, which is called the Cosmo Ball, which is a circular field with three goals, as there are two as circles. And it's played by three teams. And so, go back there. So finally, we realize the stadium, the field in the outside, and it will start in April. We'll start a kind of championship over this game. So called all the neighborhood is involved in it, and they are learning about these new rules of football that I was writing. And so it will start to be practiced in April, and it will make happen a kind of championship over there. So it was the first place. So in another place that I was deciding, try to invite me. It was a kind of auto-guesting process that I was developing for this 15 show at the same time. Some place was really inviting me, but to make this reality happen and conceptually active, I decided to try to auto-guest me in different places too at the same time. So I was asking for example, in Pompidou Art Center in Paris, to show at the same time of this big show, to show one piece that they have in their collection that they were buying 2 years ago, but they were never showing it before. And this piece is called Slow Motion. So this piece is kind of, I call it as a kind of prehistorical computer. It's just made by five panels with 150 bulbs, and you have a pupitre with 150 on-off button, and you just switch one, which is just activate one pixel of the things. So people inside the exhibition are just producing some words or some signs. And so the first time that I was making these pieces, it was in Japan. And only the first, I was defining only the first word of the exhibition, which was internet slow. Anyway, it will come, I suppose. Okay, so I was just writing the first word of the time of exhibition, which is slave, and at the end of the exhibition I just write vals, which is the anagram of slave, and during the time of the exhibition people are producing a slow transformation between these two words, and it's just asking to them, I'm sorry it's not coming, but let's see. So it's just asking to them to make a retranscription of the number of the button that they were using on the notebook, which is present in the space of exhibition, which is making me possible at the end of the show just to taking it and to reproduce everything of what we're producing during the show itself, and to make a kind of, I was making in Japan some photographs of each word or sign producing during the show, and making a book with it, which is becoming a kind of collective poetry and whatever. I'm sorry, but the connection seems not to work well. Anyway, I suppose that you are understanding the process. Let's go to another place. So another place was a kind of social and musical public house in the northern neighborhood of Paris, which is really a popular one, which is called La Goutte d'Or. And I'm developing since 2002 a work that I call Peripheral Communities, which is based on the process of shooting and editing on a way that I call a vertical editing. And the idea is trying to make a picture of a group. And I'm sorry, it's the connection. So is the technician here? Because I think I need another time the code. I think they were. No, no, but it's okay. No, no, it's just the Wi-Fi connection.
Did you connect to the Wi-Fi yourself? Or
no, they were putting some codes. It's okay, it's connected, but they're requesting for.
Where's the code?
I don't know. Let me just.
No, it's not connected.
Yeah, it's connected.
No, it's searching for.
No, no. It's activated.
What code is it asking for?
Utilise un certificat, which is not good.
Click OK. Where's your H?
No, but there is no OK. It's not requesting for it. Just saying that you don't have the good code.
Okay, I'll get the code, because I have the code for this
computer. Okay, I can't speak about during the time of connection. I can speak about this peripheral communities stories. So the idea was to let you know I was editor for a long time, for 10 years before, long time ago. And yeah, I don't know. And so I have this reflection about editing process since a long time too. And so the idea was for that, it's to make a portrait of young slammers, so people from the neighborhood that just slamming, so the things from the hip-hop stuff, sculpture. And instead of taking one slammer to put another one after, thanks. Sorry. That's it. There we go. So the process was, so instead of taking this little piece of space and time of recording and to put one to another and the other one next to the other one and blah, 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 I was decided to putting the vertical on the timeline and trying to play them together, but without this notion of superposition or whatever. It's really, the diffusion was made by, so you have just one picture, but you have the experiment. I'm sorry, I'm a little confused with all that. Okay, so the thing at the end was to question the different reality between the picture of the film and the sound track of the film. So you have one picture of 4 minutes, for example, where you have a representation of these 20 slammers, but you just have 2 or 3 seconds of them watching it. It's matching like that. But you have a multi-tracks audio stuff with the headphone, and you have the 20s reality in continuity that you it's possible to listen. So you are connected with just one of the slammers, and but you see the portrait of the other one just listening one. So this process I was developing it in different culture after that. So I went to slammer communities in Korea, in Amsterdam, in Paris, in and we are making it now. So in this show, Paris again, and in connection with London in Brooklyn. And so they were a kind of atelier of slamming for young people in the neighborhood during the time of the exhibition. And I was learning them how to shoot them for making this process of representation. And at the end, we will show the, and after that, so the young people from Paris will go to London. In London, it will be the same. There will be a slam atelier. And I will teach them how to represent themselves. And finally, we make a kind of collective portrait of everybody at the same time, but totally in the singularity of each of, the of each of them. Oh, it's super slow, I'm sorry, but it's doesn't work. So during this tour, I was deciding to showing three of the longest film that I was shooting before, and but I decided to put it in a classical movie theater. So as a really classical one, so there were 4 or 5 seances of each of films. So there were this invisible film, so which is this projection. Which is this projection of Punishment Park film of Peter Watkins that I was decided to project in the desert where the film was shot during the 70s, in 73 exactly. But there is no screen, and it's so it's the film is just going through the air, through the nature. There is a soundtrack of the film, there is everything, and this is the sun, the sunset. 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 And so the all the dispositive is disappearing. You just have the a little flux of the light, which is going through the nature. So it was really interesting to make this kind of experiment, to try to take this kind of film and to putting it in a classical movie theater. And and for, I know that it was super risky at the same time. So and I remember once when I went to one seance on one day, and there were absolutely nobody inside the room. Nobody came to see this invisible film, which is super nice, in fact. I mean, we will speak about that later. This kind of modality of exhibition is proposing different experiments that a kind of classical art center couldn't do it, I think, today. There were another film, so I'm describing, sorry, the picture are not coming. Yeah, sometimes. So the second film was a film that I was shooting 2 years ago. And the starting point was a film made by Patricio Guzman, which is called The Battle of Chile, and which is narrated historically of the conflict between during the time of Pinochet and all the story of the coup of 1973. And my idea was really to work with this notion of historical fact, and I was taking the soundtrack of this film, which is really the narration day by day during the 3 months before the coup, and deciding to go exactly at the same place where the reality of 73 was playing, in fact, but shooting the reality of 2007. So finally, you have a conflict between this soundtrack, which is narrated the reality, the historical realities, and the reality of today, of 2 years ago now. And so it's a 90-minute film, and so it was projected to over there. And this film was was shown in Venice Biennale in 2007 too. But well, anyway, I'm going from there. And there were another film too, which is a film that I made in 97. Where the projectionist is inside the room, inside the movie theater room. And the film, I was shooting this film with a French best performer for some runners that are best performers for the 800 meters and the 1,500 meters. But before shooting, in fact, I was taking the equivalent distance of the film of their best of their best performance. So if one is running in 2 minutes 0.07, for example, I was taking 2 minutes and 0.7 of the film, I cutting it, and after that I was shooting them. So in fact they were running in front of their own picture. They have to best perform to have the reality of the arrival of the track. But if they are not perform best, they will never finish the running, they're still running, and the film is cutting. So there were five different runs, and so it's really the reality of the end of the film that was interesting me, that it's a part of the film itself which is quite disappearing, but I'm quite interested by this moment. And so you have this projectionist with just performing, changing the film all the time during 1 hour and a half. Another work was to was happening in the Palais Doré, so which was the old museum for humans, which is just becoming now the national museum for historic f- for immigration history in Paris. And so it's the same. They have one piece in their collection, and I was asking for them to showing it at the same time of this show, but in the big room at the central part of the place, which is a big fresque, where there is a big fresque about the narration of all the colonization. And so I was showing this piece, which is a peripheral community that I was shooting in Dakar in Africa. So based with these slammer things and everything. So it was shown over there during 1 week in this big room of... Okay, I'm continuing. Another place was so these two public commons that I had with architectural new building in Paris. So one was in a college, which is called Rosa Park College, and so I was interesting to produce a work about this individual, about Rosa Park itself, and so I make this tribute of Rosa Park to all the building. Oh, it's really amazing. I'll show you the projects instead of the picture. So the work, I decided to really explore the work in five different places. And so one was taking place in the big stairs of the college, which was really vertical. And I was producing this mirror stairs, because this is the principal access for the building for the teenagers. And the stairs is really long to get access to the college. And so I was producing these mirror steps for that. Then I was producing a big light enseigne on the top of the building. We just write the name of it. Then there were this huge, there is a 14 meters glass structure inside the outside place for the college, for the teenager. And I was drawing on it a long story about all the black histories in 400 years before until the really civil act of Rosa Park and until today, in fact. So it's a kind of... that doesn't exist finally. And another intervention was I made a portfolio, a really precious one. I was ordering some real printing of the FSA, so the Farm Security Administration command of about photography, and I was ordering more than 60 original printing that I was laying in the library of the college for the teenager as a kind of really precious things that they can have consultation with it or just to try to make an approach about the image itself. So this is the final. And there is another light intervention. So this is the wall of drawings. Sorry, it's so slow, which is making me nervous. Okay, I'm going to another place. So it was this social and cultural small place in the suburb of Paris in one neighborhood, which is called La Courneuve, which is really a kind of Arab neighborhood. And there is a guy over there, a Texan guy, which is living there since 20 years. He has a fine, a whole little farm inside the big buildings all around, and he's developing different artistic projects or social relation projects. And so I was proposing to him to make this polylog things, which will happen each Saturday afternoon during all this show, which is based on a simple idea, just to make a collective moment with people when they are just invited to come here, and we are just, I was just putting one word on the table, as we say in French, and we were speaking about this word during all the afternoon. So there were two or three words each afternoon, and so collectively this word was defining by people, by experiment, by different level anyway. So finally there were five or six different moments which was happening for that. Then there was this show in another place which is more a classical art center, which is called Le Plateau. And I met, so it was the first places opening for the show, so it was the kind of starting point for all the show over there. So they were exhibited four different works. So there was this work which is called Return from Memory, which is just four light box which are animated, and you have this character which is just coming to in front of us really slowly on this wood bridge. And there was this work which is considered as a principal work of all this adventure in one way. it's called 10,000 Later. So I was producing 10,000 later in plaster, and which were totally organized, but anyway, I stopped again. So it was taking all the places of the exhibition, but each group of later are coming from a sound archive, from a voice of a philosopher, a scientist, or ethnologue, or whatever. But it's coming from a real document of sound that I was working. I was working to the archive of the national radio to try to find some really interesting piece of voice. And after that, I was reproducing it, and I was putting all the later in this order. But each mountain of later is corresponding to one of them. Finally, the space of the show was something like that in three different places. So when you get inside the show, you didn't know what this mountain of later is representing. You just have the name on the light, on the top of the light, of the neon light over there. You have the name of the philosopher or the other person speaking. But you don't have the original soundtrack for it. You have to go to the internet to get access, in fact, to the voice and to the, so for example, but I don't have a sound connection. Yeah, I don't know. Is it connected to sound? Nobody. Okay. Anyway. Anyway, you will go to see if you are interested on your internet connection, which is probably working better. So you can listen to the different voice of this exhibition on these audio things. And the idea was, when you go to the website, you can just listening it once, in fact, and it's disappearing after. So there were 17 different soundtrack of different people. Another piece in the show was this piece that I call As an Object. So where I'm producing some Kalashnikov, but in glass. So I'm going for that here. Okay, so I was producing this Kalashnikov in glass. Thank you. Let's try maybe the voice of Bergson.
Quel est l'objet de l'art si la réalité venait frapper directement nos sens et notre conscience, et si nous pouvions entrer en communication immédiate avec les choses et avec nous-mêmes, je crois bien que l'art serait inutile, ou plutôt que nous serions tous artistes, car notre âme vibrerait alors continuellement à l'unisson de la nature.
So I was just making you listen that, not because of, I'm sure maybe you don't understand it, but this is the only recording of the voice of Bergson, in fact, of Henri Bergson. And this recording was happening in 1936, and the National, they were a museum for speech, in fact, in France at that time, and they went to meet Bergson for a recording, and they go and they make a sound check. And after the sound check, the machine was broken. And this is the only voice recording of Bergson, finally. So he just did sound check, and he's just reading two lines of his book, Le Rire. And he just think about the notion of art, which is quite interesting for me. Okay, sorry. So for example, you have this soundtrack. So there is two sentences. It's representing 287 letters, if you're writing it. I was producing the letters, but I put it, I let it on the floor totally disorganized, so you can read the things. But yeah, for sure. Which one? There is no English one.
Bachelor?
Okay.
La philosophie traditionnelle s'occupe communément de l'homme qui pense, comme si l'homme trouvait toute sa substance, tout son être dans la pensée. Il semble que la fonction dominante de la philosophie...
Connection doesn't work.
Il n'y a pas un seul film qui montre des problèmes ouvriers ou étudiants tels qu'ils se passent aujourd'hui. Il n'y en a pas un seul, qu'il soit fait par Forman, par moi, par Polanski, par François, il n'y en a pas. Nous sommes en retard. Nos camarades étudiants nous ont donné l'exemple en se faisant casser la figure il y a une semaine. Il ne s'agit pas ici de continuer ou de ne pas continuer à voir des films. Pour l'instant, il est évident que nous devons projeter et voir le plus de films possible, et que c'est là notre but. Aujourd'hui ou demain, il ne s'agit pas de ça, il s'agit de manifester, avec un retard d'une semaine et demie, la solidarité du cinéma sur les mouvements étudiants et ouvriers qui se passent en France.
Je souhaite que le festival s'arrête.
So these things of Godard was happening during the Festival de Cannes of 68, when France were burning. And so they were trying to stop the Festival de Cannes and deciding, all the directors were meeting to decide not to continue the festival, because it was more important to go back to the reality of social realities than to speak about. So as he said at the end, we speak about life and social relation, and you want to make me speak about traveling, but he doesn't want anymore that time. Okay, I stop here, you can listen it.
Ce qui se passe dans une pièce pendant une heure, par exemple, ce qui se passe dans cette pièce pendant une heure, c'est un passage de la nature dans cette pièce. Et il monte ce très beau concept, on verra, de passage de la nature. Ah, c'est la nature qui passe. Elle passe par cette pièce et dans cette pièce.
Okay, it was Gilles Deleuze. So I go back to the Kalashnikov process. So I'm producing this Kalashnikov in glass, so but finally I'm just smashing it on the floor and I'm just showing the stuff at the end like that. You can try, I have the video over here. Let's try. So I just destroying it just the night before the opening. Oops. And the last piece of this show was a piece which is called Trouble Time, which is this huge clock that I'm producing, a classical one, but I'm just blurring the glass. And so it's a piece that it will be shown in another place in this exhibition that I will speak to you after. Okay, let's go. I was transforming the space of exhibition too. I was reversing the entrance of the museum and the way out of the museum. So the classical entrance was totally empty like that. And all the desk and the function stuff were putting at the outside of the place. So people were getting entrance by the way out. So another place. So it was a national radio program. So it's a 1 hour program. And I was using the same archive of sound of this philosopher and all these people. And I was producing a dub music. And I was mixing the dub music with this archive of sound. I try to make you listen a little bit.
La multitude n'est plus quelque chose de masse, compacte. La multitude, c'est un ensemble de singularités. Le travail, désormais, est fait de plus en plus à travers l'intelligence, mais l'intelligence est toujours singulière. On peut essayer de la contrôler avec des moyennes massives, mais la participation, la valeur, la valorisation du travail passe à travers la singularité, avec cette petite chose que chacun peut donner.
Là, c'était Tony Negri. It was Tony Negri. There is more than 35 different pieces of song, in fact. This is dub, and this dub is going to Oriental music too at the same time. But it's 1 hour program. So. And it was diffusing just once in live. I was organizing an event for listening, so people, a public one, so people were coming in one place where I was putting just the radio to be listening the live program. So finally we were more than 100 people just watching a radio and listening this program. Yep. So then I was deciding to show the Chantal Crouzel Gallery, but during the art fair in Paris, which was happening at the same time too. And I was producing this piece, which is called Relative Time, and which is, this is some Mars clock that I'm working on. So I'm producing the time of Mars planet, relatively to the Terrian one, because the revolution of Mars is 24 hours and 39 minutes, so it's just 39 minutes more than the Earth. And so this is a clock which is just slowly dilating through the day, and it's all the time late, in fact. I was producing that with some Nixies bulbs, which are some bulbs coming from the 70s, which are quite specific. Okay, I'm sorry, but it doesn't work. So I try to finish all this listing of all these pieces to try to speak a little. I'm sorry, but it's not the good way of presenting it for me. And it's confusing me in what I want to speak with. Too. Okay, I go to another place, which is another small gallery in Paris, in Le Marais neighborhood, which is a gallery where owned by one artist, which was deciding to starting that 10 years ago, or 5 or 7 years ago. And they are just producing multiples. So I was producing multiple there. And which are just some vinyl records where I was putting all the voices of this show. So all the voices that I was using for Le Plateau, for the plaster later, all the voices that I was using for the philosophic dub music for the radio. I was burning the vinyls with just one voices. So finally there were 22 different plates. So my idea was to play with this multiple notion to producing the same modules, which appears as the same modules, which is just becoming serial, but finally they are all totally singular because each voice on the disc are totally different, but you can see it, you have to listen to it. Okay, go to another place. So it was in, Le 104, it's a big place that just opened in Paris in September, in October. And it's a place for artists to produce pieces, so it's just really a place for production, it's not a place for exhibition. And so they invite me to produce a kind of working process there, and which was the occasion to, for 1 month, to show the 7 minutes before film, so the 7-screen films. So I can show a different picture if you... So it was the work that it was shown in London too. So it's a 7-screen film projection, which the concept is, I go to the map. Okay, so this is the scenario of the film. Sorry. Okay. So this is the scenario of the film. It's a drawing that I was making after the film itself, but it was the way that the film was going. And so it was, the idea was to take 1 moment, so everything is happening in a landscape in south of France, and so from the moment of this accident that will happen at once in the film, I was taking backward the time, but proportionally through the time I was going through the space. So I show you the space of crash was happening here, exactly. And I decided to make a film 17 minutes before. So I was taking the camera that I have to shoot here at that time and going for 17 minutes in different parts of the landscape itself. So finally, the starting point of the film, we are going for seven different points of view that are going to this point of this notion that which is representing the notion of event, which was played with this accident time. and this is the only moment where everybody is filming the same thing at the same time. So for me, it was the notion of the zero point of the space and time itself. But before that, you have different events. that are playing. There is musicians playing music, there is different stuff, and all together are showing at the same time in the space of exhibition, but for the reality they were totally separate for more than 2 kilometers or really far away. And so nobody have any, everybody have just the conscience of something happening at the same time, and that will be recorded, and that they will be coexisting at the end in the same space, but their reality was just a singularity finally when the action was happening. Okay, so it was important to show this work during this show, because this is a little bit the mirror of the thing that I was trying to do through the exhibition modality, to make this 15 coexistent exhibition at the same time. But this is the same process, but it's not really asking the same question. Then there were another place, which is called Le Macval, which is a kind of new museum we're opening 2 years ago in Paris, in the suburb of Paris. Oh, sorry, it doesn't work. So the work there was, I was asking to the museum to show some photographs that I did, that they are owned by the museum, which is called the Selected Recording. It's a series of photographs that I'm doing, which is just printing in one unit. You never know where it's happening and when it's happening. And I'm using it as a language. So for an exhibition, for example, I can choose five of them in the database of the Selected Recording, and I'm producing just a sentence with it. And the other work shown there was the Zona del Silencio project, so the project which was shown in the Voice and Void exhibition. And so the Zona del Silencio project is, I was going to Mexico in a desert which is called Zona del Silencio. And the story is that during the 70s, the Americans were sending a missile, and the missile, instead of going where you have to go, it was just going to this desert. And so the NASA were going there, observing precisely the desert, and they are discovering that there is a big magnetic concentration there. And this place, since this moment, apparently, since this moment, the place was becoming a kind of really strange place where Mexicans were going, observing some rabbits with ear from 1 meter, and they were seeing some extraterrestrial people, whatever, a lot of different events. So I was interested to go there and to try to have a record of all the story possible that can define this territory. So finally, I was collecting all this story on the scientific level, on one way, the really local and popular telling story, and through the mythology too, because it's going far away, since this territory have a strange attitude, if we can say that. And so I was producing, you can see it, but I was producing something there. Okay, I'm going after that. So I was making this other command for architectural building. So it was a swimming pool, which is a new swimming pool opening in Paris, made by Patrick Berger. And so I was deciding to producing a huge counter. But it's made by some mirrors, in fact, that are moving in the space, and it's representing the time, but by seconds. So there is 86 400 seconds by day, So it's just counting the time in seconds, in fact. So it was a way to make a mix between the function possible of this representation of time and really a singularity of identity of time for this place. So this is the swimming pool where you can say I'm going from 35,732 and I will go out at, so it's a new figure of time, in fact.
Maybe I have, so for example, if it works, it's have to work at some moment maybe. I think I have two or three pictures of that in real. So the mirror are just moving from the top to the bottom, in fact, and just, so I was just playing with the reflection of the two different value of the place. The one will be totally animated by the the people swimming, and the water animation, and the neutral value of the top of the building, which is not so neutral finally, but at the beginning of the project there were not this kind of things, but we can classify it as a neutral things. And so the lisibility just producing by the contrast of the both. Here maybe it works. I would like to show you on this clock, what time is it, actually? Anyway, if you go to the website, you will have here a kind of converter in second of the real time. So you can start to learn about the second clock. And the last places, so was in another gallery, in Yvon Lambert Gallery, where I was just putting in the vitrine at the entrance of the gallery 15 different travel time clock, which is this clock so I made by the with the blur glass. But there were these 15 different small clocks, but just running the same time, in fact, which was the kind of picture of this show, finally. So this is it for this chaotic listing of this exhibition. Anyway, I'm sorry about that, but it was totally deconcentrating me that I can't show what I was speaking with. But you have this website online, so you can go and try to go in different places and the way that you want and whatever. But after that, if I was speaking about that, it's more trying to speak about this notion of exhibition itself and all the work. But finally, there were more than 34 works were shown through this exhibition. So we can consider it as a kind of retrospective exhibition, but with different temporality, with different duration for the film, which are during for 90 minutes, for example, and the time of real time of speech world that I was playing in the server. Whatever, this conflict of different duration and this conflict of different times was through the space at the scale of the city was really the purpose of this exhibition. So for the viewer, for example, it was possible to get access to this show by 15 different places from 15 different levels, finally. You can get access to one and saying, okay, maybe I, at that time you discover, because there were a big map of Paris in each places, that you can have it and going to the other place after that. But to go from this place, for example, the number one, to this place in Paris, it's, I don't know, it's 3 hours. So is it possible to live with this kind of modality of exhibition? I wanted So it's for that that I'm coming back to the notion of invisibility, because finally I was trying to make through the quantity, through the amount of different places and different works, a kind of relation of the impossibility to get access to at the same time for a specific viewer. If I consider each locality, they were really a local life about each different show. After that, does the ideal viewer for this kind of project exist? I'm not sure. Because finally, there were potentially 25 people that I know that were really running for the 15 different places, which is a big exercise, finally. But so this conflict between the reality of the local and this global approach of this coexistent process was the point, the deep point of the exhibition itself. From the inside, from my point, it was super, super exciting to produce, more than anything, any other show that I was making before. So actually, I'm making the book of it, which will be published in May. So which will be the only way to have a vision of the whole. The website is the website is this kind of tool that kind of has this watch on the whole, but in front of the reality, it's a big mystery. This exhibition was a big mystery for a lot of people in Paris. Anyway.
All right, are there any questions?
It's really hard, this no, but the object that I was presenting is already, in terms of reality, totally super complex to have a vision of it. And I was presenting it on a way which is making worse. You mean, sorry? Oh, yeah. Yeah, the idea is that, but not on really on specific place for each of the works. Yeah. Not just to putting everything at the same time everywhere or whatever. It's not this notion at all. Really, each places were really specific in terms of the choice that I was making about. And in front of the work itself. When you see the big hamac, for example, through this architecture is speaking about something else. When you were inside the space in front of this building made by hands during the 13th century, and this hamac producing in 2007 by another culture and whatever, the conflict of the material, and a lot of things were happening for the reality. Actually, just it's not my idea is not to, yeah, my work is something as a whole. And each work for me is just a part of it, and it just as a result, in fact, we are thinking as a whole. We are not just working on that today, and tomorrow we will work on that. We are working. It's more complex. It's more a corail structure. Finally, I don't
but
know corail in English.
There are some there were some places in which there were very obvious connections when you use mm-hmm. the voice and you yeah. know and the radio and so mm-hmm. on. The hammock is, in a sense, for me, one of the most, it's the furthest away. Mm-hmm. I mean, maybe it's the furthest away on the map as well, but it is the furthest away. I don't know if you can say anything about that, because clearly you
yeah.
don't intend to knit them mm-hmm. closely. Mm-hmm.
No, I think it's a mirror of what the show is, because the objects were produced by a multiple of singularity in the village, so more than 35 people were involved in the producing action of this hamac. Their classical habit is to produce some touristical hamac for one body, or they were mating some 4 meters one or something, but never this idea to produce an object without any function finally were appear in their mind. And when I went to this small village that I was discovered little by accident, because the first time I was in Merida, it's in Yucatan,
And the idea was, I was knowing that a jail, the prisoner in one jail were producing amac. So my idea was to go there and try to work with them and to make them produce a little part of it, and these things will be coming a whole. But finally, it was so corrupt over there that it was quite dangerous. So I said, okay, I don't work with this with this community. And I was looking for a small village, and I went, I discovered a small village, and I went there, and as I was saying, I didn't let them know that this object will be a piece of art exhibit in a place in Paris. I was just saying my father is a giant, and I would like to produce a huge hammock for him as a present. Everybody was laughing, and we were agreed to make it. So what I'm interesting by that, and this is the way that I'm working in general, I'm going to another community, to another culture, and I try to find an exchange with them, which is not based on the classical way. And finally, they were producing that during more than 3 months. We went back during August there. We were making a film with all these people producing this object. And finally, this object was going, and they never know where it went. I will go again next year to see them with that, with these big exhibition show things. I will make a conference about my work on the small place of the village and without Wi-Fi connection, because there is no there. But anyway, it's an exchange on another level. But, and finally, the work shown inside the building is questioning something else, too. There are several stories inside the object, the production of the object itself, the time of showing it, which is the destiny of the art of today, which I'm questioning to this dispositive, is that I don't want that the exhibitioning time is taking the dominant on the process of producing something. So I'm rejecting it. So to reject it, I take it over. I take it too much. I take it just, I'm making 15 places. So it's not an exhibition anymore for me. It's another thing.
Does anyone want to?
I mean, in a sense, when you say you want it to be considered as a single kind of exhibition, I suppose what I feel as though I haven't understood. I mean, I understand, like, you go there and you say, my father's a giant. After all, I guess Europeans have been doing that for a long time. My father's a giant, would like a lot of sugar, or coffee. So it's just another
but
damn
it's
thing.
True. But it's true.
What are the relations that you're interested in between, even before one says the word sight? I mean, what are the relations? I mean, they can be here, you can reconfigure it electronically. Probably you're also configuring it like as a book. Mm-hmm. And it seems to me, this is what I think I don't quite understand, the particular sites are very strongly related, obviously, not just to the city of Paris, actually, but to the map mm-hmm. of Paris. And then there's a third level, sort of everything that's kind of outside that, but still somehow related mm-hmm. to how the objects get there. But somehow what I felt I didn't quite understand is, what are the relations that you're testing? I mean, as if you're testing how far can you disaggregate an exhibition and still imagine it's an exhibition? So to what extent then is it competing with the city or doing something else to the city?
Yeah, I think it was first of all, it's an experiment. So when I was producing that, I didn't know if it was a good concept finally, or if we can put it through the reality. And for example, I remember a young architect writer for Archistone, which is this review in France,
And she wanted to write about this exhibition, because for me, yeah, the scale of the city, it's a question, and all this process are some questions that can interest different people. And but it was, she had to write the paper 3 months before the opening. So nothing was happening nowhere. But I say, why you don't make a relation between these places without any project in it, but just go for their own realities first. Just go to link this point with this point with this point and just write about that as a kind of pre-territory of something that will happen. And she was making all article with that, without any realities in the places. But she was going for each places and speaking with the people, saying, okay, what will happen over there here in the next month or something. And she make a big travel through Paris for really a long time. She makes some documentation about her trip. She was linking the city on the way that she was never linked it before. And because finally there is no one motive of moving through the city. There is several ones for several reasons and as every movement decision. But this is an exhibition. I'm artist. I'm producing some pieces. I'm not.
But there seems like a difference between when you describe it now. I mean, it sounds, when you talk about the person you encourage to do this, as though it's, you know, not unlike projects that we know, you know, like Georges Perec or someone. You know, that you can turn the thing more towards in the direction of a certain project of sort of flaneurship.
I think that
but you don't. You keep, I mean, this is why I'm really asking you, okay, in a sense again. I realize my question's not very clear, but it has to do with the kind of different levels and what are the relations that you're trying to maintain, and how do you feel that they should be experienced? Is it that you put a physical experience as the same as an electronic experience, you know, or to what extent is this a representation, in a sense, of the project, or is it part of the project?
Right. No, it
Brian,
was.
Okay. Let Brian just ask. And then
okay.
Well, actually. Question I have in mind, it's sort of similar to Marx, not so much in relation to the map of Paris, but the map of art,
mm-hmm.
because it seems equally that each of your sites corresponds to some kind of site within a kind of taxonomy of current art practice, mm-hmm. as if you were making your own museum of all the different ways of doing art. You know, there's a performance, there's a sculpture, there's an archive piece, there's a multi-screen video piece, a piece of conceptual art, and so on and so on and so on. So that, as well as this question of the spatial relation and the distribution of the sites of exhibition, there is somehow the positions that you're occupying within the semantic space of art at present.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it's a crossing. There is three crossing important maps on this map. There is a spatial dimension of Paris itself as a kind of circle with an inside and an outside. There is this map of art that you are speaking of, a space of showing art, which is really super important. And there is another map, which is not drawing here, which is, yeah, it's here, in fact. This is the time map, in fact. And these three things are mixing together. And without, if you are missing one, finally, you are not inside the project. If I'm just showing it today through the work, saying, okay, by list, in these places, they were that, they were that, they were that. But I'm forced to make it, to introduce this concept. After that, the question, you are speaking about relation. I'm not putting the point to interest by the relation. I'm just trying to let them exist at the same time, which is quite different and deeply different for me. And I'm more focused about the coexistential process than any way of relationing it. I was making for you the walk through this website, but if you were going to this website, you will go on a totally different way. I'm not sure that you will see this piece or this piece or this piece that you didn't see tonight too, anyway. But in front of that, I don't know. For me, I was making as a tool, to answer to your question, it was really a tool during the exhibition. During the exhibition, it was the only way to have a representation for practical way to get access to everywhere. So I was making it as a part of the show, really opening on the September and everything, and people were going to getting information and all that. Just to
Can I try and ask the same question, perhaps a related question, a slightly different way, because you said that in some way 7 minutes before was the same process but different. Mm-hmm. Perhaps if you could say something about that difference, it's another way of...
Okay, so 7 minutes before, it's really a picture of it, of all that. It's a picture of these different realities happening at the same time, but in different space, which are not connected in the term of a frame possible. So it's a picture of that, and it worked for that, and I really liking it. But that, it's playing the same scenario in one way, but true realities. And so it's impossible to record in it. Actually, I was making a film.
Oh, there is a difference. There isn't an explosion.
Yeah.
There isn't the accident.
Yeah, yeah.
There isn't a convergence.
Yeah, I was exploding during the work. No, we were making a film during all the process because I was super interested by that, and we were starting really last February when I get the idea. I said, okay, we have to film all that, what is producing. Because in the real, it was producing, for example, I have every day, I have a 17 people meeting in my studio coming from these different places. And I was saying to them, because really I didn't have the money for producing this kind of show. And nobody was ordering this show to nobody, finally. So I was taking the budget of one place, saying, okay, I will take $1,000 from here, putting over there to make possible the reality there.
Do you mean they didn't know that it was
No, they were super exciting by the proposition, but they didn't know how it was possible to making it. And I was saying, okay, for the printing, simple things, for the printing of the invitation card, how do we do? How many places? Because the optic was not that everybody, people from art, that can receive potentially 6 or 7 places. They are in the mailing of 6 or 7 different places of this show. We will receive 7 different cards of Melik Ohanian from the voice to design. I didn't want that. I say, okay, it's impossible. You just say, I'm not interested by that. So, how it's possible to produce differently that? So, we were producing 3 different invitation cards finally, but which are based on the same process, but for a different type of printing. So they were 3 different cards. After that, for example, one place, this small place in the suburb, social place, doesn't have any money to pay for mailing, addressing, whatever, and printing something. I say, okay, in one of the places, how does it work over there? But we have some annual contract with the printer, so we can't take some money. We don't have real money. We have connection with printer. I said, okay, make me a list of what you have, everybody. And I was taking it and I was making that to make possible everything everywhere. And so for the producing stuff, it was super, super interesting. Because the mutualization, for example, which is something that totally disappeared in this process, was the essential things. If you don't mutualize the thing, it never exists. Nobody needs that. I need it, but nobody needs it.
As a last point, I mean, it seems, and often the work shows it as well, as though what you're trying to kind of push out of all this, even though sometimes you're marking your difference from it, is actually a kind of substance that we don't normally think about, which I would call synchronicity. Exactly, things that happen at the same time, including that they don't.
Depends on the duration.
But in which, as it were, while we're absolutely used in a school of architecture to thinking of space as a kind of the location of social solidarity, I mean, it does seem that in a sense, you're trying to push, and it's very complicated, like a notion of synchronicity. The fact that there is a certain bond, though I'm not sure what it is that you're saying, that comes about from saying, at exactly the same moment I do this, you, while quite somewhere else, mm-hmm. are doing something else as well. It reminds me, I mean, which I think, you know, in a sense is quite instructive, in the short story by Heinrich von Kleist, I can't remember, it's the Marquise of Von O, there's this extraordinary first sentence, but which opens up the possibility, although it sounds mad, of synchronicity. He has this incredibly long sentence explaining that at a certain moment, the volcano erupted, the earthquake began in Lisbon. And then it sort of goes on for about four lines, and then there's a comma, and he says exactly the same moment someone in Germany committed suicide. And it is this strange problem, but I'm not sure that kind of resolves anything. But it does seem to
The synchronicity
to come out.
Is something in from the, it's interesting me in from the notion of duration. Without any notion of duration, there is no point of synchro for it's a problem of scale of duration. I'm more interested by the reality, and it's already a scientific point since some years, is that, and I was playing with that in another book and another work, it's just that, okay, we are far away from the Big Bang notion. There is no point zero for time, and we are behind that. And behind that, we have what? A several notion of times at the same times. And I'm more included in this form of the, oh, it's possible. It's not just a moral and social and cultural notion of multiplicity. It's more that I'm totally convinced through my body, my experiment, whatever, my intuition, that there is this several times at the same times. It's not this several events at the same time. I don't care about that. But I'm totally feeling the several times at the same time. And it's not a schizophrenic stuff or whatever. Maybe I'm a I'm a strong schizophrenic guy, but no, I think it will go through the philosophy in the next years, and the way that we are living is just telling that to us. And it's more interesting to try to make one picture of a group, but with all the singularity of the group at the same time happening, which is, there is a new way of representation to find through that. So I try to work on that since 10 years now, and try to continue, anyway.
I think you should really end at that point with your passionate statement. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.